This recording will share some of the features of the CODAP provided in Lesson 9 in the OpenSciEd High School Chemistry Unit on Survival in Space. In order to use this CODAP, you'll work with the table provided when you first open the link. You'll see that there are cities, whether they're near water, and a number of temperature variables in the latitude and longitude of each city. The first thing that we'll do are to look at the graphs. To open a new graph, you simply click graph. And it opens a scatter plot, but it's empty. In order to make sense of data using this graph, you will grab a variable from the row that's gray in the table that we first looked at. So in the gray row, we see city. I'm going to drag city to the x-axis of the graph. It will turn yellow and I drop it there. However, there's not a lot going on here. There's nothing on the y-axis. So I need to grab some kind of information that will go from zero up. So I'm going to grab one of my continuous variables, the summer average high. This helps me start to see what's happening with the cities in terms of patterns and their relative summer high temperatures. However, this doesn't help me understand anything related to water. So the last thing that I'm going to do is a little bit tricky, but I'm going to grab the near water variable, which is a categorical variable. It's either near water or not near water. So I'm going to grab this variable type, and I'm going to sneak it in underneath the blue cases header, and there will be a bar that turns yellow and highlights when I do that, and it will ask layout side by side by near water. And so I drop it here, and the data will split by whether the city is near water or not near water. And this makes for a little bit of a pattern. And you can drag in different types of variables to change your graphs. So this is the average summer low. And you can drag in all of these to check out whether being near water makes a difference in the summer, in the temperature you choose. That is how to use a graph and to drag and drop variables onto the axes and to use a category to distinguish types of data. The next thing I'm going to show you to do is to use the maps feature. Now, this data set is interesting because it has a field called latitude and a field called longitude. CODAP can read the word latitude and the word longitude, and it automatically knows that these two categories or columns can work together to place the cities on a map. So let's open a map and see what happens. When I open the map, all of these variables automatically get populated as latitude and longitude onto the map. Some of them are labeled already with the place name, the city name, and some of them are not. So Charleston is not labeled, Tucson is not labeled, but San Francisco and Seattle are. However, these places all look orange. There's really no data represented for temperature on this map at all. So once again, you can drag and drop in order to make data visible on this map. So let's try again with the summer high. If you grab it and pull it onto the map turns yellow. And if you release, a colorful bar appears at the bottom from lighter to darker, representing the amount or difference, a gradient of temperatures. So if I look at the map, Houston is fairly dark and has a fairly high summer average of 94. Seattle, on the other hand, has an average summer high of 78. It's on the lower end. And I can move my cursor around the map and see differences in the summer temperatures. And that's how to use the maps function. If you'd like to check out other variables to make conclusions about the effect of water on a city's temperature patterns, you should try out all of the different types of variables inside this map feature. Thanks.